Hey guys, so we are back again with a new video, and in this video I'll be telling you how to take photos using the default camera app that is present inside your Android device. So this is how the app looks like. So if we click on take photo, it will take us to the default camera application, and then if we click on this camera icon to take the photo, and then if we think that the photo is okay, if we click the check mark, then the photo is displayed inside this MS view that is present inside the main activity. So let's jump into Android Studio and see how it is done. So here I am going to create an empty activity. Let's give this application some name, take photo, and click on next, or rather finish. So we are here inside our main activity. So now let's go to the resource file, that is the layout folder, activity-main.xml, and let's go to the design tab. And here let me remove this hello world from here, and we'll insert an image view here, and let's give it some avatar that is something like this, and let's give it a width of say 300 dp and a height of 200 dp, and let's insert one button here which says take photo. So let's change the title to take photo like this, and now we select both of them and right click, and we center them horizontally, and again we center them vertically. Now let's go to the text file of this XML file. Now let's create an on click listener for this button. So on click take photo would be the method, and let's create this method inside our main activity. So here we are, and now let's just do some housekeeping. We'll be making a lock T, that is our tag for our comments. Now let's get our image view, that is image view like this, and now let's just find this image view, and image view equal to find view by id r dot id dot image view. And now here inside the take photo method would be the meat of the video. So first of all, we'll create an intent, that is intent equal to new intent. And intent would be of type media store dot action image capture. And now we'll check if any application is inside the device that will be able to handle this intent. So what we'll do, we'll make a if check, if intent dot resolve activity get package manager is not equal to null. And if it is not equal to null, then we will start the activity for result. And here we need to pass in two parameters. First is the intent and second is the request code. So let me zoom in a bit. So let's create the image code first. So int request code for image. And this should be equal to any number according to your choice, but this should be unique. So here inside start activity for result, we'll pass in our intent and our request code for image. So when the camera application takes the photo, it encodes the photo in the return intent delivered to the onActivityResult method. So let's implement that method. So onActivityResult, and let's remove this super onActivityResult. So first what I'm going to do, I'm going to check the result code, or rather the request code. So if request code is equal to our request code, that is what we sent, if this is true, then we'll proceed. So firstly I'll make a switch case, switch result code. I'll explain this in a moment. So what that result code means, that was the result okay or was the result cancelled by the user. So here we have two cases. Case one would be result okay, and let's break it, and second case would be result cancelled, that is cancelled by the user, again break, and the final would be the default. So default would be break, simply like that. And now let's log something inside here. So loggy, result was okay. I'm just logging it that the result was okay, and here I'm just logging result cancelled. So now if we run this application inside our device, so let's see what happens. So this is a previous application which was running. So here if I click take photo, it goes to the camera app, And I can move this camera by pressing the Alt on my keyboard and then moving my mouse. And if I click this picture, and let's open our log console and let's paste it main activity here so that we can get only the logs for the main activity. And let's increase the size of this also. Now let's say if I click cancel, that is press the cross button here, we see that we get result was cancelled. Now let's just take the photo again and let's click on this check mark and we see that the result was okay. Now how do we get the image from this onActivityResult method? So it's pretty simple. So we are expecting a bitmap. So bitmap equal to data dot get extras and dot get data. So this key here, that this data key here would contain our thumbnail image of the photo we have taken, and we just need to cast it to the bitmap type. And now if we use our image view dot set image bitmap to be the bitmap, then our image view would have the bitmap that we have just captured. So if we run this code again, so now here I take a photo again and I press on this check mark, and here we have our image inside our image view. So guys, this is all about this video. The whole code is available on GitHub. The link will be provided in the description below. So if you have liked the video, do hit the like button. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, do subscribe to my channel. And if you want, you can support me on patreon.com. I'll provide the link in the description. So thank you. Bye-bye. Tata. Take care. Have a good day. God bless you.